So this video will start section 5.7 and we'll complete it. So section 5.7 goes over moral calculations in chemical equations. So we've learned how to write balanced chemical equations, which are kind of recipes for chemical reactions. And so the information we get from a balanced chemical equation is the number of moles of each reactant that combine and the number of moles of each product formed. And so if we look at this example given here, N2 nitrogen gas plus O2 oxygen gas make two NO molecules that are also gas. And so this, looking at this equation, we can extract the information that is below that says, let's first talk about molecules. So if you combine one molecule of N2 with one molecule of O2, you can make two molecules of NO. It's really like the recipe that tells you the proportions in which the reactant react and the proportion of product that you can make. Of course, make only one molecule react with another molecule is not possible. And we typically talk in number of moles in chemistry. So the ratio is the same. If you say you have one mole of N2, it will react with one mole of O2 to make two moles of NO. So the chemical equations gives you those ratios or proportions of reactant and product. And so you can use those mole ratios from the coefficients in the balanced chemical equation to convert moles of one compound into moles of another compound. And so the roadmap would look like this. You start with moles of A and you end up with moles of B. And the conversion factor would be a mole-to-mole ratio, a mole-to-mole conversion factor. So if we keep using the example we had earlier, where we have N2 reacting with O2, giving two molecules of NO, there are multiple conversion factors that can be written from the coefficients that are provided by this balanced chemical equation. Because we don't see the ones in front of N2 and O2, but the ones are implied here. Coefficients of one are not written, but it's understood that it's one molecule or one mole of N2 reacting with one mole of O2. So you could use that as a ratio of, and that would be the first example here, of one mole of N2 over one mole of O2, and that can be used as a conversion factor to convert moles of O2 into moles of N2, right? The second example of the conversion factor that says one mole of N2 will make two moles of NO, so over two moles of NO, that's a conversion factor that would allow you to calculate a number of moles of N2 if you know a number of moles of NO produced. And the third example, one mole of O2 over two moles of NO, would be used if your given amount is in moles of NO and you want to convert that to moles of O2. So using, you can see here how using the coefficients in front of the molecules, you can write ratios of moles of molecules and do some conversions from moles of one kind to moles of another kind. And that's why it is important to write your units fully. And as I said in the previous video, you need to specify moles of what, right? It is important here because otherwise you don't know where you're going. So let's go through an example to see how we apply this. So let's say in the chemical reaction of iron and sulfur, how many moles of sulfur are needed to react with 1.42 moles of iron? And so you always need the chemical equation when you need to solve this kind of problem, right? The chemical equation has to be given. And so here, what is given in, as you know, what is the measurement given? It's 1.42 moles of iron. So I will write that under the iron here to show that it's what is given. 1.42 moles of iron are what we start with. And the question is asking for how many moles of sulfur will be needed to react with those moles of iron. So the question mark is under sulfur, and we wonder how many moles of sulfur can we make are needed to react with that. And so that's the given, and that's the amount we are looking for. And the other information that we have, because it's a mole-to-mole conversion, you need the chemical equation because it tells you the ratios into which iron and sulfur react. And here it says that 2 moles of Fe react with 3 moles of S to make 1 mole of Fe2S3. But the question is not interested into the product. It's only interested into the two reactants. So you focus on those two. And so we can write this equality that says 2 moles of Fe, and the equal, you can read it as will react in this case, because these two are reactant, will react with 3 moles of S, sulfur. So let's write this again in the usual format that I use, where we have the steps here laid out. So state the given and needed quantities. And so this summarizes what is given, what is needed, and the information that is given, the chemical equation. Write a plan to convert the given to the needed quantity. And so that's the roadmap, I sometimes call it. And so the roadmap will show that we have moles of iron to start with, and we will we want to convert those to moles of sulfur, and we will use a mole-to-mole conversion factor. Next step, you want to use coefficients from the chemical equation to write mole-to-mole factors, and we already found out that it's 2 moles of iron that will be needed to react with 3 moles of sulfur. So that's the equality that comes from the coefficient of the chemical equation. And so out of this equality, we can write two conversion factors, as always. And here, because we start with moles of iron, we can see that we will need to use the second conversion factor so that we will cancel moles of iron. And so when you are ready to write the problem, the full calculation, you start with your given amount, 1.42 moles of iron. It's in the numerator, multiply by the conversion factor such that you can cancel the starting unit of moles of iron. So 3 moles of sulfur over 2 moles of iron. And then you're ready to type this on your calculator, 1.42 times 3 divided by 2 equals, and your calculator is 2.13. And here, whenever you have a mole-to-mole conversion factors from the coefficient, it's necessarily exact numbers. It's exactly 2 moles of iron that will react with 3 moles of sulfur. So these will never be limiting. And so then it's only the given amount that limits the number of sig figs you will get at the end. And so we have 3 sig figs in 1.42. So we'll keep 3 sig figs in the answer. And so we keep the calculator answer as it is because that's 3 sig figs. So 2.13 moles of sulfur will be needed to react with 1.42 moles of iron. Let's go through another example of this time calculating the moles of a product. And it really doesn't matter if you know, you're looking at two reactants, a reactant and a product, or two products, the process is the same. You just focus on those two, either reactants or either products, or reactants and products that are, used in the text of the problem. So, propane gas, C3H8, a fuel used in camp stoves, soldering torches, and specially equipped automobiles, reacts with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide, water, and energy. How many moles of CO2 can be produced when 2.25 moles of C3H8 reacts? And you're given the combustion reaction of propane, right? You remember how this is a combustion reaction because we have propane containing only carbon and hydrogen reacting with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. So that's a combustion reaction here. And they release a lot of energy. And the delta above the arrow tells you that you need to bring a spark here to get the reaction started. So let's extract the given amount we will start our calculation with from the text. So it says, when 2.25 moles of C3H8 reacts, so that's the given. Let's write it under the C3H8 to remind us that we are interested in that reactant. And the question is asking how many moles of CO2? So the question is asking for moles of CO2. So you will write under moles of CO2 under CO2 that we are looking for the number of moles of CO2 here. So that's the needed amount at the end. And this equation, it's like a recipe that gives you the proportions in which propane reacts with oxygen and how much carbon dioxide and water it produces. And so here we have an implied coefficient of 1 in front of propane and a coefficient of 3 in front of CO2. And so because you only want to focus on those two because that's what the question is interested in. And so out of these two coefficients and, you know, reactant and product, we can write an equality that says 1 mole of propane will produce 3 moles of CO2. And notice here the equal sign, I say will produce because here CO2 is a product. And so you keep those proportions of 1 mole of propane gives 3 moles of CO2. And so let's write this again in the format that I usually use. And we have the steps reminded for us here. So state the given and needed quantities. And so here again, 2.25 moles of propane, we need the moles of CO2 and the given chemical equation is written here. So the plan, the roadmap will look like this. We start with moles of propane and want to find how many moles of CO2 we will produce from that. And so it's a mole to mole factor that we need because we are only dealing with moles. So we will use the coefficients from the chemical equation to write our mole-to-mole factor. And we already saw that out of the chemical equation, we know that 1 mole of propane will produce 3 moles of CO2. So we can write that as an equality. And out of an equality, we can write two conversion factors. So which of the two conversion factors will you use here? So the answer to this lies into the given amount. You look at the given amount, it says moles of C3H8. And you want to cancel that unit with the conversion factor. So you will want to use the first conversion factor that has the moles of propane on the denominator so that it cancels the moles of propane in the numerator of the given amount. And so if we write the full calculation, or let's start with your given amount, 2.25 moles of propane. This is in the numerator, remember, multiplied by the conversion factor. The conversion factor has the moles of propane on the bottom so that we can sell moles of propane. And we see that now we are left with moles of CO2, and that's the desired unit. So we know it's correctly set up. So in the calculator, you do 2.25 times 3 divided by 1, and that's 6.675 moles of CO2. Here again, the 3 moles over 1 mole of propane are exact. The coefficients are exact numbers. And so we have 3 sig figs in the given amount, so we keep 3 sig figs in the final answer. And so we keep it like this, 6.75 moles of CO2 will be produced from 2.25 moles of propane. So let's go through a learning check. Using the balanced chemical equation, how many moles of CO are produced from 3.5 moles of C2H6? So please pause the video and try to work this on your own before you watch the answer. So here, the given is 3.5 moles of C2H6, right? So you want to write it under the C2H6 formula of the chemical equation to emphasize the fact that you want to focus on that reactant. And the question is asking for how many moles of CO? So under CO, you want to write, question mark, moles of CO. So this text tells you you will want to focus on C2H6 and CO. And out of this equation, balanced equation, we can find the two coefficients of two. Oh, hold on. Yes, so the given amount is 3.5 moles of C2H6. The needed number of mole is the number of moles of CO produced. And so I was saying, out of the chemical equation, we can extract the proportion between C2H6 and CO. And it's 2 and 4, right? And so the 2 in front of C2H6 says that 2 moles of C2H6 will produce 4 moles of CO, right? Those coefficients, you add the unit of mole and write the formula, and you have your equality. As always, from an equality, the roadmap here will be that you have moles of C2H6 and want to find moles of CO. And so the conversion factor that we will need will have to have moles of C2H6 in the denominator to cancel the moles of C2H6 from the given amount. So we will use the equality like this, with 4 moles of CO on top over 2 moles. Can cancel the starting unit. So if we write the full calculation, it looks like this. Start with the given amount of 3.5 moles of C2H6. Multiply by the conversion factor written such that the moles of C2H6 cancel. And we see here they cancel. There's one on the numerator, one in the denominator. And we are left with moles of CO, which is what we wanted. In the calculator, you do 3.5 times 2 times 4 divided by 2. And that's 7. The calculator answer is just 7. Again, when you want to round properly, the 4 moles of CO over 2 moles of C2H6 are exact. These are exact proportions. exact numbers, and so you look at the given amount for you know, to decide on the number of sig figs. We have 2 sig figs in 3.5. So even though the calculator answer is just 7, you will need to add 0.0 to make it 2 sig figs, right? Otherwise, it will not be 2 sig figs. And, you know, that's not as precise as it could be. And so that's 7.0 moles of CO that are produced from 3.5 moles of C2H6.